The GX2009 is not in operation as a gas detector while in calibration mode. Although it will respond to gas in parts of AirCal, AutoCal, and OneCal, there are no gas alarm indications. Take the GX2009 to a non-hazardous area and turn it off if it is on. Press and hold the air button, then press and hold the power mode button. When you hear a beep, release the buttons. The first menu item in calibration mode displays the date screen. Use the air button to move forward through calibration mode. When you get to the last menu item, the start menu item, continuing will take you back to the beginning of the menu. When you arrive at the item you wish to enter, press and release the power mode button to enter that item. When you need to increase or decrease a numerical value, use the air button to change the value. When adjusting a numerical parameter value, it is possible to reverse the direction of adjustment. To switch from increasing to decreasing a value or decreasing to increasing a value, do the following. With the parameter flashing on the screen, press and hold the air button and immediately press the power mode button and then release both buttons. The direction of adjustment is now reversed. When you are done using the menu items in calibration mode, use the air button to scroll through the menu items to the start item. At the start screen, press and release the power mode button. The GX2009 will begin its startup sequence. When the date screen is displayed, press and release the power mode button. A screen appears with the year flashing in the upper left, the month and day in the upper right, and the time in the lower right. Use the air button to display the desired year. Press and release the power mode button to save the setting. The month setting flashes. Repeat steps 2 and 3 to enter the month, day, hour, and minute setting. When you save the minute setting, you return to the date screen. Find a fresh air environment, an environment of normal oxygen content, 20.9%, that is free of toxic and combustible gases. When the AirCal screen is displayed, press and release the power mode button. A screen appears that displays the current gas readings and prompts you to press the air button by displaying the push air message at the bottom of the screen. Press and hold the air button. The LCD prompts you to continue to hold the air button. Release the air button when the release message is displayed. The unit will take a few seconds to adjust the fresh air readings, then indicate end to the right of the battery icon and return to the AirCal screen. The AutoCal menu allows you to perform a span adjustment simultaneously on all channels. Before entering the AutoCal menu, perform a fresh air adjustment. Performing a span adjustment requires the use of a calibration kit. The following procedure describes a span adjustment of all four channels using a calibration kit that includes a four-gas calibration cylinder, a 0.5 liter per minute regulator, a calibration adapter plate, and non-absorbent sample tubing. Press and hold the air button, then press and hold the power mode button. When you hear a beep, release the buttons. The first menu item in calibration mode displays the date screen. Use the air button to move forward to the AutoCal menu choice. At the AutoCal screen, press and release the power mode button. A screen appears that displays the calibration gas concentrations that the GX2009 expects you to use. If any of the displayed concentrations do not match the calibration cylinder concentrations, or if you want to turn off the AutoCal function for a channel or channels, press and hold the air button, then press and momentarily hold the power mode button. Release both buttons as soon as you hear the buzzer sound a beep, and the AutoCal LEL channel will display. You can scroll through all the channels by pressing and releasing the air button. When the desired channel is displayed, press and release the power mode button to select the channel for a calibration gas value update. In this example, the combustible channel has been selected and the current calibration gas value is 50% LEL. Use the air button to adjust the calibration gas value to the desired value. If you want to turn the autocal function for the selected channel off so that a span adjustment will not be performed on this channel, set the calibration gas value to off by adjusting the reading down from the lowest value or up from the highest value. Press and release the power mode button to accept the displayed value. The previous screen will then return. Repeat these steps for any other channels that require calibration gas value updates. When you are done updating calibration gas values, use the air button to scroll to the escape screen. Press and release the power mode button to return to the screen that displays the calibration gas values. Use the sample tubing to connect the calibration adapter plate to the regulator. Attach the tubing to the adapter plate on the inlet side. Confirm that the regulator on-off knob is turned all the way clockwise, closed, and screw the calibration gas cylinder onto the regulator. Push the adapter plate onto the GX2009's sensor face. Make sure the adapter plate is oriented with the sensor names on the adapter plate matching up with the sensor names on the instrument. Press and release the power mode button. The LCD will display the current gas readings and AutoCal will flash. Turn the regulator on-off knob counterclockwise to open it. Calibration gas will begin to flow. Allow the gas to flow for 2 minutes. Press and release the power button. The GX2009 will attempt to make a span adjustment on all channels. If the span adjustment is successful, the LCD will display pass on the screen before returning to the AutoCal screen. If the span adjustment fails, the LCD will show fail on the screen, indicating which channel or channels failed. The alarm LEDs will flash, and the buzzer will sound a double pulsing tone. Turn the regulator on-off knob clockwise to close it. Remove the calibration adapter plate from the instrument. Remove the regulator from the calibration gas cylinder. Leave the regulator connected to the calibration adapter plate for convenience. Store the components of the calibration kit in a safe and convenient place. Before performing a span adjustment, perform a fresh air adjustment. To enter calibration mode, press and hold the air button, then press and hold the power mode button until you hear a beep, then release the buttons. Use the air button to move forward through calibration mode until 1 cal is displayed. Press and release the power mode button to enter. Press and release the power mode button. A channel selection screen appears that displays the CH4 channel. Scroll through the channels using the air button until the channel you want to span adjust is displayed. Use the sample tubing to connect the calibration adapter plate to the regulator. Attach the tubing to the adapter plate on the inlet side. Confirm that the regulator on-off knob is turned all the way clockwise, closed, and screw the calibration gas cylinder onto the regulator. Push the adapter plate onto the GX2009's sensor face. Make sure the adapter plate is oriented with the sensor names on the adapter plate matching up with the sensor names on the instrument. Press and release the power mode button. The current gas reading for the selected channel is displayed. Turn the regulator on-off knob counterclockwise to open it. Calibration gas will begin to flow. Allow the gas to flow for 2 minutes. Adjust the display gas reading to match the calibration cylinder's target gas concentration. Use the air button to change the value. To reverse the direction of adjustment, with the value flashing on the screen, press and hold the air button immediately followed by the power mode button, and then release both buttons. The direction of adjustment is now reversed. Press and release the power mode button. The GX2009 will make the span adjustment and will return to the channel selection screen. The channel that was just span adjusted will be displayed. If you want to span adjust additional channels, repeat these steps for each channel while gas is still flowing. Make the reading adjustment right away since gas has been flowing for more than 2 minutes. If you need to calibrate more than two channels, use the AutoCal menu item to calibrate the GX2009. Turn the regulator on-off knob clockwise to close it. When you are finished with span adjustments, scroll to the screen that indicates Escape. Press and release the Power Mode button to return to the OneCal screen. Remove the calibration adapter plate from the instrument. Remove the regulator from the calibration gas cylinder. Leave the regulator connected to the calibration adapter plate for convenience. Store the components of the calibration kit in a safe and convenient place. When the refresh screen is displayed, press and release the power mode button. Two screens begin alternating, prompting you to answer whether or not you want to run the refresh function. To run the refresh function, press and release the power mode button. The discharging screen will be displayed and the fill inside the battery icon will begin to flash. The GX2009 is now discharging the batteries. If you want to abort the battery discharge at any time, press and release the air button and the unit will return to the refresh screen. When the unit is done discharging the batteries, the buzzer will sound a double pulsing tone, the battery icon will flash, and the turn-off screen will appear. Press and hold the power mode button until the unit turns off, then release it. Recharge the GX2009's batteries.